Today is Tuesday, July 19, 2016. We are at the campus of Pastoral Orientation Center at Palarivattom, Ernakulam, Kerala, India. We have a golden opportunity to speak to a philologist, Reverend Dr. George Kurukkoor. He has studied several languages and knows the history of the Aramaic language. He teaches Sanskrit at seminaries and he teaches here at P.O.C. George, thank you so much for giving your time to us.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes. The first question that I wanted to ask on behalf of the Aramaic Project is, could you please enlighten us on the history of the Aramaic language in connection with the history of India?
Certainly. I am only happy to speak about that. Before 7th century BC, there were commercial relationship between the people of Babylonia, Sumeria, and so on. And our spices were taken by them to European countries, even to Greece and Alexandria. When St. Thomas came to India, we must remember that so many Jews were here. Any businessman could speak in Aramaic language to one who comes from Palestine. A man in Peshawar can speak to a man of Antioch in his own language. And when he came to Kodungallur, he could speak to these people who were here in Aramaic language itself. So Aramaic reached here almost in 7th century BC. In the 1st century when St. Thomas came here, he could speak to the Jews. There were 7 commercial centers in Kerala, international commercial centers in Kerala. One most important one was in Kurukkoor. So he could speak in his own language to the people who are living in India, the Jews. And with their help, they converted other people, mainly from Buddhism, from Jainism, and from Aryans or Brahmins. And that is the beginning of Indian Christianity here. So we must understand that we have so many Aramaic words in Tamil language and in Malayalam language because one of the Semitic languages, Dravidian languages are actually Semitic languages. It belongs to one family. So all our aboriginals speak the language so close to the language of Aramaic. That is well known and it is already researched work. We have more than 30 languages which are almost closely related to our Lord's language. We are sure about that, there is no doubt. So they were not quite strange when they came here. So they could speak in their own language. And we must understand that until 9th century AD, the Aramaic language was an international language of business. And Persia was extended to our Punjab. So their language was spreading here until AD 9th century. That we must know. So,
sorry to interrupt you, what was the breaking point? What was the historical reason for that date? Why did it go out of?
Going back, in BC itself, the Aryans, so many races from North, East Europe entered India through Punjab. And they brought a language which we now called Vedic Sanskrit. And they have adopted some our words to their own language, but they became more important in India. And their race became more important. And the Semitic races became uneducated, and we did not get so much of education in those centuries. Education itself was mainly done by the Jaina sannyasis and Buddha sannyasis in India. Jainism and Buddhism almost died out almost at the 8th century AD.
Okay.
Then there was no education at all in India. Very few schools there were run by the Brahmins, or only for Brahmin children. So people studied Sanskrit, but nothing else. Our history is different, because our people were so much interested in Syriac. We are calling Aramaic language Syriac in India because it is a Greek name, because it was used in Syria. That the language used in Syria is called Syriacos by the Greek people, and we adopted that name. And our modern Kaldaya Syriac is a refined Aramaic language, refined Aramaic languages. So we call it always Syriac. So the Syriac language were so much favored by the Christians in India, because they say this language to pray is given by Mathoma. The disciple of Jesus Christ himself has taught us this language, so we will never abandon this. That was our condition. But when the Portuguese people came, they found that something is wrong here and there. It is not like a European country. It is not like a European manner that our people are living. Our people are living just like the Hindus live. And we have the Christian faith, but socially we are Hindus. And they were much troubled by our situation. So they wanted to introduce the Latin language and Roman rite. But it was strongly objected by our people. I am happy to say that Palackal Malpan, who was very strong in our community in order to keep this language, Syriac language, for our liturgy. Well, one must remember that not only for liturgy Syriac was used, but for other things also Syriac was used. I myself have old documents which are written in Syriac. Language is Malayalam language in Syriac. It is our prescription, or medical prescription also were written in Syriac. I have kept so much of prescriptions like that.
You mean to say Malayalam text written in Syriac script?
So certainly there were Syriac scripts where Malayalam was written by written in Syriac script.
Kherson
then we call it a Kherson Libi. We have produced four letters, special letters for that, for Yaga Aram, for example. In Syriac there is no Ya. So we made a new Raha for, and such letters we were making, and Ja, and so on. I have studied all those things, and I have so many books in that language. So as regards to the Christians, they were well versed in Syriac. One thing we must admit. But only after the 16th century AD, because of the introduction of Syriac, of Latin and Portuguese, and later by English, our people began to forget our Syriac. Our forefathers were saying, our father, not in Pater Noster, but Abundushmeya Naskandashmahu Tese Malkusa. Our father was said in Syriac itself. Our grandfathers were saying like that. And many people were very often asked, how could they celebrate a Mass? But this Mass as it is, the liturgy as it is, as we find it, has been brought by the people from the Middle East. Because it was a developed one, almost a developed one, but we had very little of prayer, very small quantity of prayers. That was sufficient for us. Because Holy Mass is the Last Supper of Jesus Christ. What he did do, our forefathers also did. Not without long prayers. Just like now you see in Western Syriac, so long prayers are kept. for this. All the people, the monks who produced all those prayers, there it was not necessary for our forefathers. They had a very little liturgy. But they were 100% Christians. We must always remember that they stood for the Syriac, stood for the St. Thomas, and they lived for Jesus Christ. There was no doubt. From our tradition, we can understand that they were perfect Christians, keeping the liturgy in Syriac and studying Syriac. Many missionaries from Europe have written that there are so many doctors here, in well-versed people in Syriac. And there are so many books in Syriac, in Kerala. There were so many schools, we were calling Malpanis, which were giving training for the priestly training centers. And I believe that our ordinary people, before building so many churches in India, in Kerala, they simply stood somewhere and they were reciting a prayer, certainly. So what prayer they recited, what Jesus Christ taught them. Abundu Vashmiya Neskanda Smahe Se Malkusa. That was the prayer for them. The Hail Mary, the first part of Hail Mary they may have recited. Second part they brought from the Europe. And only so much of prayer they had. And there were many people think that we did not know anything of Bible. But in 15th century, we have a great testimony of saying a priest from India in Venice that we have so many books and the Bible in Syriac, in Kerala itself. So we had a glorious past until 16th century, when European people came here, they wanted to Europeanize our people and Latinize our people. Then there were so much of confusion and troubles. And our people tried to keep Syriac language for our prayer until very recently, 1962. I myself have studied the Holy Mass in Syriac itself. But later I had to celebrate the Mass in Malayalam.
When was your ordination?
My ordination was in 67. And then onwards I began to do service in the churches.
Where was your ordination?
I studied in Mangalapur Seminary. The ordination was in Cathedral, Kodavangala Cathedral Church. Ordained by Mar Matthew Potharamuri. And then I began to serve in some churches. Serving in the churches, I began to study and I got highest marks in MA, first class and rank. Among priests, I was the first one in 80. And then I registered for a PhD in Madhura Kamaraj University because some professors who came for Viva requested me to take a PhD in linguistics. So I went there.
What was the topic of your doctorate?
My doctorate is in linguistic analysis of Christian worship. So I have analyzed all the missals from 16th century until 1980. So analyzing all these 18 books, I composed one grammar for the liturgy of Christians, for the Latin writer, Syrian writer, Marthomites, Jacobites, Chaldeans of Trichur. And all these people's books were collected and were translated. This was written in English. And it was not published, only 7 copies are kept in universities. It was difficult for me to publish because it is so costly. And linguistics is not interested for common people.
Let us go back to your seminary days at
yes.
Mangalapura.
Yes.
What was the musical scene there? Syriac music. How much Syriac music was?
But we were taught the Syriac prayers, mass order, the missal, only when we became the deacon. Before that, we were taught to recite the canonical prayers. Before that, there were nothing of Syriac was used. The only thing is that we had studied some Syriac from the petit seminary, minor seminary. We had studied Syriac, and there we kept all the books of Syriac, and there was no real teaching there. They were more interested in Latin and other languages. Those people were teaching French, German, and Greek, Hebrew, and so on. We all studied those things, but Syriac was not a topic for teaching. But only for us, from the petit seminary, we got the training in Syriac. And then we studied Syriac there in seminary for prayers only, not literature.
First Mass was in Syriac or Malayalam?
No, it was in Malayalam, translation of my translated book, Malayalam. Because it was from 62, Malayalam began to be used. But 67, my first Mass. The old generation, including my mother, was sorry that I could not say the Mass in Syriac. They were so much interested in to hear Pugaruhun. She was so much interested to hear that.
Oh, wow.
And so many people told me, you could say it. And then because of the compulsion of old generation, until 1980, I celebrated the Syriac Mass on St. Thomas Day in my parishes. So old people, I gave giving information to the people and giving some information how these things are, prayers are like this. For example, where is the cradle, the hymeninen, which is the Our Father. All this I was.
Can you intone?
That is your mercy has helped us to approach you. Have mercy upon us.
Can you say the Our Father in Syriac?
Certainly.
Yes. I recite during my personal prayers. My personal prayers, I recite this Our Father in Greek, in Syriac, in Latin, and so on, so that I can remember always. My now, prayers. As a philologist, when you recite the Our Father in Syriac, East Syriac,
yes.
Tell us something about the pronunciation of.
Pronunciation, the problem is exact Syriac. Syriac is a Semitic language. Its pronunciation is not like the European people. I am wonderstruck that the people come from Rome who studied Syriac, they never pronounce exact Syriac words. The Syriac words must be pronounced just like Tamil is pronounced.
Now, on the other hand, Syriac did not have the word Ra.
Yeah.
So it is an adaptation from Kerala, from South India. So this language, can you say that the Syriac language has undergone transformation?
Any transformation.
In the Indian context?
Indian context, Syriac words became different in phonetics. According to phonetics, there was some difference. Because of our nature, we have changed certain phonemes. So there are so many examples. I have written more than 300 words like that, but I don't remember now. So many things, Ramba, Ramban.
Gandisha.
Yes, Nakar, Yes, Yeddikar. Yasnakar, Yadukar, there are differences there. And there are certain differences where, traditionally formed here in India. I have studied all the ancient Semitic words used in India. In India means in Tamil Nadu and Kerala. I suppose to publish that because Kaldul has given more than 30 words, I think. 30 words, similar words. And so many people have guessed that our Amma, Abba, and all these are from Amen. The Tamil had itself Amen. The Tamil, there is Amen. There is Ramba. There is Am. All these things in Tamil itself we have found.
So do you mean to say that they adopted from Semitic language?
Semitic language, because the first people who resided in India were Semitic people. There is no doubt. In South India, certainly. Not in the Northeast. From Northeast, from China, Japan and so on. But here, you see our Sindhu Nadidara Samskaram. Then our Bombay and Gujarat. Then our Punjab. Then our seashore to this Kerala itself. All these people were all Semitic people. Their languages are living. In Punjab also, Sindh also, there is Semitic people and they are using the Brahui language is their own language. Very Semitic. The Protestant missionary has found out so many similarities of these languages. Unfortunately, Catholic priests are not interested, and I have advised so many people who were going there to collect their languages, but they never collected. When some people come to India to hear, I ask them, what do you say for your father? Then say Abba. How you call your mother? They call Emma. And so many words, just like the Aramaic words. The words which were used by their forefathers. I asked them to say the words which your grandfather is saying, not yourself, because you have studied Hindi. So what words they used? They say Vaita, Emma, they say Abba. Abba is Abba. And all these words, I have collected so many words from people who come from North India. From Sindh, I have not collected any word because we could not find anybody from Sindh because they are Muslim country. They are keeping their old language and it is said that they are keeping our Christian faith in hidden, as a hidden treasure in Sindh. Their language is our own language.
Now, earlier you mentioned that your mother was disappointed that you couldn't do your first mass in Syriac.
Yes.
What was the general sentiment about the transition from Syriac to Malayalam
and
that period?
And our old people, that means including my mother, my old generation never liked to take part in a Malayalam Kurbana, Malayalam Mass. They wanted to hear that Syriac music, Syriac prayers. My mother is especially was the daughter of a sacristan, so she could know all these things.
Really? Wow. She was a daughter of a sacristan.
yes. So she could remember all the prayers and all the musics of Syriac, everything she knew. So she said, oh my God, you could not say in Syriac. But I told her, in St. Thomas Day, I shall say celebrate the Mass in...
In those days, during the Mass in Malayalam, did you say the institution narrative in Syriac?
I don't remember, but our people in the churches, they began to recite in Malayalam. Then our old generation felt that, oh, it is not a Mass. It is not sufficiently pious. And our people did not sufficiently teach the people. Our priests did not sufficiently teach the people to take part in Malayalam liturgy. And that was a very great failure. And even now that stands. When we say Sorgasna Yangada Vidave, we were saying Abundusmiya. Our forefathers knew of Avundasmiya means our Sorgasna Yangada Vidave. And there was much mental difficulty for the people, old people. But the young generation was happy because they understood the words, and it was shorter also. It was shorter. Young children were loving. But we were feeling that much difficulty in reciting. My opinion was every child must be taught to take part in a Syriac mass. It is not so difficult, because all the Muslim children are studying and by hearting their Quran, our children, many serious prayers at least, but we never did that. Christianity does not have one language. That is the greatest failure for Christianity. For Islam, they have one language everywhere in the world. That language will become the most the major language of the world. Very recently we are showing the signs of that. But Christianity was the first language of Christianity was Aramaic, Jesus and the, but they were knowing four languages. They are on vernacular language, the Romans, Latin language, and the Greeks, Greek language. And they were knowing the Hebrew for their prayer. They were studying four languages. Without any doubt, I am sure, our Jesus and all the disciples knew all the four languages. But the problem is, one language Jesus used must have been kept up. But when they wrote the Bible, they wrote to other people. So they wrote in Greek language. Only Matthew wrote in Syriac, you know. And that book is not found also. Only copies are found. That is a very great failure for us.
So what should the Syro Malabar Church, because the Syro Malabar Church is special because they use East Syriac, which is closer to...
Close to the Palestinian or the Jewish tradition also. We are keeping so much Jewish traditions. You may have heard of our Kurukkoor. Which the Mary and Martha made for Jesus' supper when he was going to Jerusalem. We are using so many things from the Jews tradition. Nowhere in the world.
Yes.
Nowhere in the world. Pesaha, where thesis was written in France. A priest wrote a thesis in France, but they did not pass it. They said, Jews speak of Pesaha. And there is nothing in the world. And he came to me and asked me to write a letter on the practice of Pesaha in the houses.
In Kerala.
In Kerala. And I wrote in Malayalam, and he translated and put in an English magazine, and that was given to the professor. Then they agreed that there is Pesaha in Kerala. In other words, nobody knew what is Pesaha. We are celebrating it in Pesaha in our house. It is just like a mass. We eat the bread just like the holy bread. We never allow any particle to fall down. We wash the plate in good water and pour the water where the people could not step. We are so much devotional as regards our Pesaha. Even now at my house it is so. And in cities these people do not know what is Pesaha. They never make this bread.
Puliyathappam.
Two kinds of bread. One is INRI, Indriyappam. INRI, Indriyappam. And the another is Kalthappam. Kalth is a Hebrew word. You must understand that it is a Hebrew word used by our forefathers for 2000 years.
What is Kalthappam?
Kaltha means burned appam.
Oh,
it is burned. The fire is under, it is fire. Above, it is fire. Fire and fire. In the center, this appam is kept. So it is burned from below and from up. And that is kalthapam, it is simply Hebrew word. Nobody has written those things.
In your childhood, when you celebrated the Pesaha meal at home, what kind of songs did you sing?
We did not sing any song, but we simply said our Father, a prayer which Jesus Christ has taught. The Father will say, we are going to eat this bread and to drink this milk. Milk, we are making milk instead of wine. To remember our Lord's Last Supper. Our Lord has taught to pray like this. He will recite Our Father. Then we will recite the Our Father. Then the Father will take the bread, pieces of bread to each child. And the wine will be poured to each child and we will eat. Just after making signs of cross, we go out. And we keep silence. On Pesaha, we never played. We never run. We never made a noise. On Pesaha and on Good Friday, we never made sound. Even Hindus did not climb on trees in our place.
Oh, wow. Oh,
they
respected our
sentiments. Oh, yes, certainly. In my neighborhood, no Hindu worked on those days.
Wow.
No Hindu sweeped his mutam.
Huh.
Because we were Christians, we were living among Hindus, no? They were keeping perfect Pesaha. And we were giving this kalthap, not kalthapam, but this indriyappam to them.
Uh-huh.
At every home, we will take kalthapam and indriyappam. Indriyappam means INRI. That is also another problem for Christians in Kerala. Why should we call indri? INRI, why did this Latin translation came to India? But I have an answer. Because the Indian Christians had so close relationship with this Alexandria. Alexandria was a Latin country. Their language was Latin. From there, they copied this. I have searched so many crosses in India, but only one cross has got Mooikulam, has got the in Syriac words. Yudhanmar Rajavai Nasraikar Nisha.
In Syriac?
In Syriac language. Nowhere.
Where is this?
Mooikulam, here this.
Near Alua.
After
Alua. So there is a church with a cross in Syriac script?
Syriac inscription.
Do we have a picture of this? Is it still there?
Certainly. You could ask a picture from them. I myself have kept, but now I cannot find where it is. I have got a copy of it.
That would be fascinating, because most of the ancient crosses we have Persian script.
That is we call it Pallavi Kurish.
Pallavi
Kurish, there is a Pallavi Fasha, Pallavi language. Pallavi language is not read now. Nobody knows. In 9th century, the Muslims conquered Persia and they abolished this language. And Arabic was used. And we very, very few people have ever studied this Persian language. I suppose that it is not correctly read. We cannot find it may be Kannadi Eluthu. It could be read from a mirror. In those days in India, they were reading in mirror, Kannadi Eluthu. Directly you cannot read. You can read in a mirror shade. That may be the solution to that language, I suppose. But I could not, I did not find time to search for that. I like to search that also.
Well, you are like a walking encyclopedia. In your brain.
Very often people called me walking encyclopedia. I was teaching Malayalam MA and I wanted to go from there. Then the teacher said, Father, you must not go. You are the only walking encyclopedia here. You must not go.
Yeah.
When I was in Madurai University, the professor asked me to stay there and take the job of a professor in university. I told him, I am a Catholic priest in Kerala. A Catholic priest need not take a government post. You can give it to a boy who can help his house, his family. I need not earn money like that. So I left. So Dr. C.J. Roy got him. He was the director at that time. Department of head. He is still living. Recently he said, I had told that priest to stay in there and to teach there, but he simply went out.
The question I wanted to ask, looking to the future, what do you think Syro Malabar Church should do to bring a little bit of that Syriac experience to the present generation and the future generation?
Certainly we can do it very simply, you know. Now Jacobite Church is teaching Syriac in catechism classes here.
In catechism?
Instead of catechism on Sundays, there are catechism classes, Sunday
yes.
class.
Yes.
They are teaching the Western Syriac. The story of Western Syriac, I did not say. When the Jacobites came, they have brought the Western Syriac. That is the difference between two Syriacs. And now they are teaching. If our bishops are willing, the children could be taught this alphabet, some simple prayers, some sentences, and then some the order of the mass. It is not at all difficult. I find to study a language is not at all difficult. I studied the most difficult languages very easily. For Sanskrit, for me, I studied it very early because I wanted to study the Ayurvedic treatment. If you want, you can do. I am sure that our Kerala people must do that. I am really sorry that we are abandoning our Syriac traditions. Syriac traditions are, we have so many traditions we are abandoning, no? The Pesaha, for example, in cities they never use Pesaha. They never use. There are so many words which we are using from our own forefathers. We are not using those words. There are so many other things which from the Jews we got, and we have abandoned. That is too bad. I am really sorry about it. Whenever I could time to speak to catechism teachers and to the priest, I often told about this, that we must keep our Syriac tradition as far as possible. But now the children are more interested in scientific topics, you know. But they could study some language, some history.
Yeah.
For example, no child will say that Kodungallur was an international commercial center. Because in our books, they never wrote international. Chumma, they say that St. Thomas came here and spoke to the Brahmins. That is only what we taught, no? But they were all Chinese people, the Sumerian people, the Greek people, the Romans, and the Jews. It was an international
port.
And we had already 7 international people. The Jews were, so many Jews were here. I myself have found the places where Jews lived, and Yudhakadav, for example. Yudhakadav there, in Meenachilar.
Really?
Yudhakadav. I asked, why are you calling it Yudhakadav? Then one old man said that it was the commercial center of the Jewish people. And the government recorded it like that. Yudhakadav. Yudhanmar kadana kadav. And there were so many Jews here. In our Mailukumbu there was Jews. And I know their descendants. One of my relatives is a Jew. They became Christians many centuries ago. And we must keep that tradition of Jewish tradition and the Aramaic tradition. Our children do not know what is Aramaic. The word itself they do not know. We must have taught them in the catechism. That must have been done.
Yeah.
We have made so many catechisms, so thousands and thousands of copies are sent. But the basic things are not taught. Basic things. But Jesus Christ was speaking Aramaic language. But you ask any young man here, he will not say.
Jojo, earlier I was thrilled to hear you mentioning the name of my collateral ancestor, Palackal Thoma Malpan.
Oh, certainly, I am very happy.
With
I am very happy.
Attention to the Syriac heritage. Could you please elaborate on his role in preserving this tradition?
When the Portuguese people came, they wanted to give an education, European education in India. They thought that the Syriac people are schismatics or heretics. So they wanted to make the people just like the people in Portugal. So they wanted to teach only Latin. They wrote to the Pope also to abolish Syriac from here. But fortunately, Pope did not allow.
So they wrote to Rome
to abolish this Syriac from the and take away and burn all the Syriac books and to teach only Syriac, only Latin prayers.
Pope did not allow.
Wow. We have records of that. Pope did not allow. You may do anything, but you must not destroy Syria. That was the Pope's stand.
Wow.
Yet these people gave the education in Italian, not in Italian, but in Latin and Portuguese. And so many people were taught here, no? But the problem is, our people loved the Syriac tradition so much. They cannot even think about another thing. So our leaders, especially the fathers who were teaching, they were called Malpans, you know. They were so troubled with this. That is why they have tried to keep this Syrian tradition. That is why they wrote to Rome to get a Syriac bishop here. But the Portuguese people did not allow a Syriac bishop to enter here. That is why the Netherlands people, businessmen, brought Jacobaya bishops to this place, to Indian Sea, and they traveled in North Kerala, came to Tamil Nadu, and then came to Kodungal. Because the Portuguese people were keeping away, you know. It was so difficult that the Portuguese got the power to rule on India, rule on Kerala. India is totally India. Before the 8th century, we were not 8th century because before the 13th century, in 13th century, there were so many Christian centers all through India. In 1022, there were a Syriac bishop in Patna. We have a proof of it.
At Patna.
1222, a Syriac bishop. In 1675, there was a Syriac bishop in Kashmir. We have the proof in Persian history. I have researched all these things. But there were so many Christians in India. But when these Portuguese people came, there was very few Christians here. Our Christianity almost died out, went to Islam because of Islamic attack from the 8th century onwards. And 1033, the Muslim people came to even our Nelakal to make all the people to convert to Islam. And after Akbar, what was the case? Our Shah Jahan were asked to come all the people, all the Christians from Bengal to the Ahmednagar. Thousands of people by walking they came. 99% died out. Very few entered there, and they were made slaves and prostitutes. That is what the Shah Jahan has done. But we never taught our children what Shah Jahan did.
Wow.
When we study Shah Jahan, we will say he is a great great emperor who made this Taj Mahal. But he did this. You can read that in the records written by our missionaries.
Wow.
I have read all those records by the missionaries.
Yeah. As you're coming back to Palackal Thoma Malpan.
Palackal Thoma Malpan, Malpan's position in the history of Syrian church in Kerala is an important position. He really is one of the most noble, most notable, but that means most important man in the history of Syrians. I am sure that if our people are really studying our history, because our people are not studying history. If our people were really studying history, they were the greatest Malpan of Kerala. I have no doubt about it. I have studied so many seminaries kept run in Kerala. No? In our Karakun also there was a seminary. In Valkun there was a seminary. There were so many seminaries. But this man, a courageous man, to fight against the forces which wanted to destroy Syriac. He wanted to keep this Syrian tradition of Kerala forever. I am really happy to think about him. I have kept some documents about him, not much. Some historical books, not documents, but some historical books, some descriptions about him. Not his own description I have never read. So people could collect those things from home, I suppose. Yesterday, library, they may find some. I have asked some priest in Rome, but they could not find anything on Palackal Thoma Malpan's writings. He must have written so many things, no? Against this Portuguese also he must have written, but we did not get anything. We must have found out. It is better that somebody, you must take initiative to write a doctorate thesis on Palackal. There are so many people who are writing thesis upon a book, on a person they can write, no? That would be very nice. I myself have helped 18 persons to write theses in Malayalam. but no child came to write on Syriac, on Syrian tradition. And such things they did not take. Only they took Western education and Western history. Our ancient history is not touched. Only Nangachivitl Achan tried to do some work. You have read Nangachivitl's?
No.
Oh my God, you must certainly buy that book. Nangachivitl from Trivandrum. He has wrote two volumes of books. This real story of Kerala history, Kerala Christians.
Oh, wow.
Then the other thing is from Kottayam Seminary. From Kottayam Seminary, which man wrote this Kerala Sabha Yatra? I forgot his name. We have a big book, but it is not detailed. But Nangachivitl has researched and he wrote. I think that he is either a Jacobite or a Malankara. He was a principal also. Asia Marcoma suffered, not in the period. You could ask some libraries. If you cannot go get a copy, you can take a photostat copy and keep. That is so important, a book. You must study. Because without learning how we were in ancient times, we cannot write a thesis upon a man who lived in last century. There are so many books on Kerala Christian history. There are so many people wrote, but not so vast.
Thank you, George, for this erudite, very scholarly discussion.
I am really extremely happy to talk something about Palackal Malpan and Syriac. That is the first chance I got to speak on this subject.
Wow.
People did not call me to speak on in Syriac tradition or about Palackal Malpan or about our first seminaries. The first seminaries before the Bangalapur seminary and Puttamballi seminary, there were so many seminaries, no? But nobody is researching about those things.
Yeah.
In Karakunda there was a seminary. My mother's father was the sacristan there. These things are not interested by our people. Anyhow, I am happy that you are interested.
Can we conclude with a Syriac prayer or something that you can recite in Syriac?
We can conclude our words with an Our Father and with a blessing also.
Yes.
Amen.
So we shall
thank you, George. Thank you so much.
Thank you, my dear. I must thank you. I am so thirsty of these things.